All right, you know what? Just hold on 1 second. A little help here. Little help. Thank you. Thank you very much.
What are you doing?
Some of them aren't wearing green either.
Yeah,
well, you're not going to get to pinch them. You know why?
What are you doing?
You know why? Because I'm making you disappear. That's right. Yeah. Whoa, you're totally gone. You should probably
disappear too by getting it.
She's our neighbor from 4C.
Oh, hi. Nice to meet you. Very nice to meet you.
Look, I just came over to ask you to, in a very neighborly way, if you could just keep the sex down.
What?
I'm sorry. Did you just say we need to keep the sex down?
These walls are thin, honey. I hear you two going at it every night and twice on Wednesday.
Oh.
You gave her a little something extra for Humpty.
No.
Wow, okay. Wow, I am really sorry about that, Dot. I am so embarrassed right now.
Embarrassed? Pisha! I mean, she's the one that's screaming her head off. Either you're giving it to her real good, or she's one hell of an actress.
We're really sorry. We'll try to keep it down.
Don't apologize. I understand you're a young married couple.
Oh, we're actually
we're not married.
Living in sin, you dirty birdie.
See this?
I don't care.
Okay.
It's okay. I once had a mixed relationship. He was a Red Sox fan. I was a Yankees fan. It would never work. I don't judge.
Okay.
Okay, well, great. Thank you for coming by,
yeah,
Dot. That was great. We will see you, around.
Okay.
No. Don't rush me off. I brought you a few, welcome to the building housewarming gift, if you will.
Oh, well, God, no, you didn't need to do that.
Yeah.
Really, you didn't need
First,
to do
I
that.
First, I bought a ball gag for the screamer.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
And some lactate. I haven't heard Fox that loud since my ex-husband.
No.
And for you, Astroglide.
Okay, see, we don't need this, Doc.
Yeah.
We really...
I hate you masturbating every morning before you take a shower. If you use that, you come faster and I'll get back to sleep.
Okay, well, Dot, it has been really great having you over. Thank you for coming by, and the bees.
Enjoy.
Thanks. We will talk to you. Wow. That was crazy.
Do you masturbate?
What? No. Sometimes.
Am I not enough for you?
Yes, you, of course you are. Okay, now, don't you get angry at me, Miss Loud Fart.
Fair enough. Oh. These walls must be really thin.
Do you think she hears us now?
I cannot hear a thing.
Carpet's looking mighty clean. Any idea how it got that way?
No.
The room in there, and look what I found! This was in a box!
It's a sheet of bubble wrap. We work in a bubble wrap factory.
Yeah, but according to this sheet, this is the first sheet of bubble wrap ever created!
Seriously?
Yes! I mean, that's gotta be worth something, right?
Yeah, I mean, the first sheet of bubble wrap ever.
Right?
They said to be on the lookout for anything that might be valuable.
Do you think there might be a reward?
Yeah, I'll give them a call.
First.
Jerry, what the hell are
you
doing?
I heard it too. I don't know. I think it came from over there.
Jerry, that's just the first piece of bubble wrap. That belongs in a museum.
I'm so sorry. I just couldn't help it. It was calling to me.
We work in a bubble wrap factory. You can walk 20 feet and find bubble wrap.
I know, but it's not my fault.
Look, just don't pop anymore, all right? The rest of them are intact.
Okay.
Jesus Christ,
Jerry! I don't know, I can't help it! It's calling!
What do you mean it's calling? It's right there in front of you! This belongs in a museum! We could get a reward for this! This is a testament to the people who've worked enslaved in the packaging industry! Stop it! You're like a 3-year-old child!
I just needed to pop it.
You've got a roll of bubble wrap at your desk!
But this one is right here! I'm touching it!
Just put it down, okay? Stop. Just give it to me.
Just one more. I can't.
Put it down on the table. Put it down on the table.
Oh God. Oh my God, Jerry. I don't even know what happened to me. I knew I shouldn't have done it, but it was. I couldn't help it.
You're like a child.
Oh God. Oh. Fred.
Yeah.
You say that's valuable, right?
Oh, yeah, this is.
Hey there, guys.
Got a lot of value.
Oh, hey! Hi! Sam?
How's the. What is that?
Sandra, it's nothing. Just. No, we're just cleaning. Doing a good job. Look at that.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's nothing. That is the first piece of bubble wrap ever made!
Really?
According to the look.
Oh. The first ever.
Yes?
Wow. Did you call up to the office?
I was actually right about to do it.
But then we saw that it was almost already unpopped completely.
Oh, yeah? Huh. So it is.
Oh, yeah.
That's a shame.
That is too bad.
Yeah.
It's gotta be worth a lot.
Probably, huh?
There's gotta be 50 years of air just
old
left
air,
in these
least.
Old little cells just...
No,
thanks. I put your bags in the guest bedroom.
Oh, good. I'll get them.
We really appreciate you for babysitting Andrew.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I love the little guy. Yeah. We'll go in my room and watch TV.
Yeah, great. Last time you were here, you left a couple of things in the guest bedroom.
Oh, okay. I'll get them later then.
Yeah, you know, Andrew is really curious, and I found him playing with something of yours.
Oh, did I leave my blue sweater here?
No, it wasn't a sweater. It was, at first I heard it vibrating, and I thought it was his Tickle Me Elmo, but it turned out to be your body massager?
Huh?
You're... Your mechanical pleasure device?
Honey, I have no idea what you're talking about.
The red one, double-sided?
Oh, my vibrator. I was wondering where I put that. I've been looking for it all week.
Yeah, it was big.
Yeah, it's fun.
Mom, Andrew had it in his mouth and he was gagging on
oh
it.
Oh my God. Is he all right? I'm so sorry, is he okay?
Mom, you cannot bring those things here.
But I use it every day. Sometimes twice.
I don't need to know that.
Oh, well, it's no big deal. It's just a dildo. If you want one, I'll get you one. They sell them online. There's a big sale.
No, I don't want one. You can buy that online?
Oh, yeah. You can buy lots of stuff online.
No.
Vibrators, fruit-flavored undies, all sorts of toys.
No.
It's great.
Mom, why are you buying these?
Well, honey, ever since your father's died, I'm single. And I'm in my early 50s. I need a little fun, too. Besides, you know, I use the toys.
Why? Toys? Why? What do you need
well,
toys
honey,
for?
Well, honey, I've joined an online senior swinging singles sex club.
Are you kidding?
No.
Is that safe?
Yeah, we meet in upscale hotels. It's safe.
Are you having sexual intercourse with these men?
Yes, I'm having sexual intercourse with strange men in dark alleys.
Oh, I'm serious.
No, I'm serious. You're getting way too uptight.
No, next you're going to tell me you're a dominatrix and you beat people.
No, that's ridiculous.
Thank you.
Actually, I wear a Japanese schoolgirl uniform and I like bondage.
Oh, you're freaking me out, Mom. You're freaking me out.
You're going to wake Andrew. Calm
I
down.
Can't. No, I can't. Honey. I can't breathe.
You know, I have something.
Men.
Calm you right down. Massage you.
Double-sided.
There. Here you go. Yeah, it's here. There. Better?
Oh.
Isn't that nice? Mother knows best.
What's the name of that website?
I'm for you.
was a delicious smoothie you made yesterday. Get any help with it?
No.
Today in class, when you stated your name, you said your name was Timmy, which is good. Good start. But then you told me to eat a crap pie and die.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to you were referring.
Really? Timmy? You don't remember telling your teacher in front of the 13 students to eat a crap pie and die?
I must have blanked it out, if it ever occurred at all.
Timmy, I heard through the grapevine that Jimmy Durango paid you a dollar to tell me that.
I don't reveal my employers.
It was a dollar, Timmy.
Do you know what you can do with a dollar, Miss Hendricks?
That's not the point, Timmy. The point is you can't just go and do anything for money.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't, Timmy. Like, you can't hurt someone for money.
I kicked Jimmy McIntyre in the wiener for a dollar.
Timmy, that is not okay.
Oh, really?
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 Really? That's not okay.
When I receive a dollar, Miss Hendricks, I take action.
Okay, Timmy, is there anything you wouldn't do for a dollar?
Nope, a dollar is the key to my heart.
Okay, surely you don't mean that.
Well, what do you think I wouldn't do? For a dollar.
Okay, Timmy, I don't think you would blow up the principal's car.
It's done.
No, Timmy, I don't want you to blow up the principal's car. I'm just using it as an example.
I got it.
No, really, Timmy.
I got it, it's done.
Timmy, don't do anything to the principal in general.
I understand.
Okay, you know
it
what?
It's done.
Okay, I will pay you a dollar to stay away from the principal.
Oh. Okay, it is done.
You know what, Timmy? I will pay you $10 if you don't do anything for a dollar ever again.
$10?
Yes. I am bribing my students now. This is good.
Okay, it's done.
Okay, you can go back to recess now, Timmy. Oh yeah, one more thing. Did you glue me to my chair?
That was prepaid.
Great.
Fine, relax, honey. Breathe.
Okay, the contraction passed.
Good, I don't want you to have the baby in the car.
I don't want to either. That's why it would have been nice if we called an ambulance.
Look, we talked about this. We can't afford an ambulance.
Thanks, honey. Thank you. You are so supportive. The only reason I'm having a baby is because you were too cheap to splurge on condoms.
I used a condom.
The plastic bag out of the hotel ice bucket?
Same principle.
Very different results. My mother is right. She said not to marry a cheapskate, but did I listen? Whoa!
See, we didn't need an ambulance. And I'm not cheap, I'm frugal.
You're cheap. I hate this car. It's a death trap.
Oh, it's not so bad.
It's a Yugo.
Whoa, look out, buddy. Lady with a baby.
So you didn't fix the horn.
Oh, no, we're saving money for the baby, honey.
Oh, I just don't know if I can go on like this.
You're right. If we make a left up here, we can bypass the tolls.
No, like this. With you and now a baby? Oh! Maybe some music will calm me down. Can you turn on the radio?
Nope.
You didn't fix the radio?
No, I sold it.
Why?
Well, we need money for the baby's college fund. We don't need a radio.
Maybe we don't need it. Maybe it's not essential for the car to work, but I like it.
I could sing. You lost that love and feeling. Oh, that love.
Shut up. Please, you're driving me crazy. I feel so hot and sweaty.
I have a Thomas guide.
What happened to the GPS I gave you?
I sold it with the radio and the fan and the everything else. Oh, here we are, see?
That's it. I refuse to get out of this car until you change.
That's just the baby talking.
No! This is it for me! I just can't do it anymore! I need a car, horn, and an air conditioner, and a radio!
Alright, look, you're right. I'm sorry, alright? I love you, and you can have whatever you want.
Really?
Yeah.
Because I was thinking after the baby was born that maybe I wouldn't go back to work.
And now, Acme Tonight brings you Excess Hollywood with your hosts, Jessica Lovelace Chandler and Travis Ritchie.
Hello, welcome to Excess Hollywood, where we give you what's hot, hip, and happening here in Hollywood. My name is Travis Ritchie.
And I'm Jessica Lovelace Chandler. Let's get this started, shall we?
Despite John Mayer's recent kiss-and-tell revelations about her sex life, Jessica Simpson says she remains, deep down, a trusting person. But then she also admits that, less deep down, she's kind of a stupid person. American Idol news! When Simon Cowell's fellow judges were asked about the soon-to-be Mrs. Cowell makeup artist Megan Hussaini, Ellen DeGeneres commented on how pretty she was, other chick judge said something that nobody remembers, and of course Randy just said, I gotta tell you, she's a little bitchy, dog. There's definitely some bitch problems there. And actress Evan Rachel Wood has exited the cast of the Spider-Man musical currently on production on Broadway, prompting many to comment, they're doing a Spider-Man musical? Wow. And now with some inside scoop on some of the Oscar shenanigans, our Jessica Lovelace Chandler.
Army. It's Army. Thanks, Travis. The one problem that people had with the Oscars this year was that they failed to pay tribute to the late actresses Bea Arthur and Farrah Fawcett. Here to report from heaven are Bea Arthur and Farrah Fawcett.
Hi there.
Hello.
I worked in the industry for 60 years, and I was funny till my last day. How many actresses can you say that were funny after 60 years? How about 6 years? I mean, look at Roseanne. Oh, wait. She was never funny.
She wasn't. I've been working since 1976. I got my poster on the roofs of college boys' rooms since... Well, since 1976.
Well, call me a college boy, because I know I had one.
Oh, me too. Well, we really are sorry that you two couldn't get the attention that you deserve.
Well, actually, Jessica, after the Oscars last night, we were so hurt that Farrah and I drank our feelings together, and then we put together our own slideshow in memoriam to us.
God, would you press play?
Enjoy Hollywood.
I'm too sexy for my love, too sexy for my love, love's going to leave.
Jessica, actually, that's Corey Hart. Yeah, he's still alive.
Oh, thank someone at random this week to follow on Twitter. Her name is Sarah Killen. She's getting ready to graduate high school, and she goes by the username Lovely Button, which I'm pretty sure is the phrase Cosmo Magazine uses to describe the clitoris. Killen's life has changed since O'Brien's decision. She now has 20,000 followers on Twitter, gifts pouring in, and offers for interviews. Do any of those interviews include The Tonight Show? Well, it seems likely as Jay steals all he can from Conan. Two and a Half Men is allowing Charlie Sheen to return to work, despite his being charged with holding a knife to his wife's throat. The move to let a violent, volatile addict like Sheen return to set is, in my opinion, the stupidest move since the last episode of Two and a Half Men. And now, with more on the latest Hollywood gossip, we go back to Travis.
All right, well, thank you very much, Jessica. Since Two and a Half Men was greenlit, in my opinion. There's a lot going on in Hollywood, and we have an interview with three ladies who are always with their finger on the button. The Kardashian sisters, Kourtney, Kim, and Khloe. Hello, girls.
Hi.
Hi, girl.
Hey, well, you all look beautiful, as usual.
Thanks.
Well, how are you guys doing?
Good.
We're good.
I'm great.
I'm really great.
I'm really, really great.
Okay. Well, so what is happening in Hollywood tonight?
Well, with all the Oscars last weekend, we're trying to catch up on movies since we didn't get to see many.
Oh, let's see it. The Foot Locker?
Yeah, The Foot Locker. That chick won for directing.
It's called The Hurt Locker?
Sorry, how am I supposed to know? I'm busy with a bebe.
Yeah, and I'm busy boning my big black husband, Lamar.
Yeah, well, I'm busy, too busy with my perfume called Kim Kardashian, sold exclusively at Sephora.
Yeah, you'd like to smell like musty badge.
Badge.
Jealous.
You're jealous because I'm married.
You're both jealous of me because I have a baby.
Yeah, well, I'm the prettiest.
Oh, yeah, no, jealous.
No, you're jealous. You're jealous. You're jealous. You're jealous.
Stop fighting, please.
We're not fighting. We love each other.
We're sisters.
Center for one final note, because on a serious note, actor and 80s teen icon Corey Haim did die this week at the age of 38. Some of us feel sad, and on a personal note, some of us are sadder than others, because my life so closely followed his films. He was an awkward freshman who became an unlikely football star, and so was I. He had a license to drive when he was 16. And so did I. And last but not least, he fought both werewolves and vampires. And I really enjoyed watching him do it.
Well, you know, that's it for Excess Hollywood. I'm Jessica Lovelace Chandler.
And I'm Travis Ritchie. Good night.
Thanks so much.
Honey, I don't know which tie goes with this suit.
Why don't you just call 1-800-ASK-A-GAY?
Right. 1-800-ASK-A-GAY, this is Rick. How can I help you? Hi, Rick. I've got a navy blue suit and a light blue shirt, and I don't know what color tie to wear with it. It's all in the accessories. You want a tie with a bold pattern with both colors that'll pull it all together. Thanks, Rick.
Hi, I'm Darcy White. I've been fortunate to have my own network of gays to consult with on everything from fashion to food and restaurants to theater. So I wanted to give those who are not as fortunate to have gay friends the same privileges. 1-800-ASK-A-GAY.
My husband and I are going to Broadway. I want to see Mamma Mia, but he wants to see Phantom.
Well, the good news is that your husband is definitely straight because he has no taste in musicals. And Mamma Mia, it's fun, but wouldn't you rather see something good? Nothing says Broadway like Patti LuPone and Gypsy.
1-800-ASK-A-GAY is there for you when you absolutely need to know the latest gossip.
So then, Elizabeth is all, I think Bush was the best president ever. And then Whoopi is all, oh honey, you real pretty, but you dumb.
Oh my God, that Elizabeth is so full of herself.
I know.
So then, they bring on their guest, Bill O'Reilly.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Imagine the hours of fun you'll have with your own special GBFF.
Oh, a 1998 Rubicon Cabernet, very nice.
Call 1-800-ASK-A-GAY. That's 1-800-275-2429. Call now.
Heard you having an orgasm last night. Any idea how that happened?
Maybe.
Church bingo.
Right.
Cool. You have a nice head.
Thanks.
I hear it might rain this week.
Yeah, me too.
I always carry a rain poncho.
That's very smart.
It's my phone. It's Twitter. I'm tweeting.
Oh, what's your Twitter name? I'll follow you. I'll follow you.
No, it's embarrassing. I've been tweeting about our date.
Huh? Oh, me too.
Really? Well, what's your Twitter name?
Just type in my name without a space. You want to get out of here?
Let's go. Hey, that first guy gave you the finger.
Hey, screw you, Bandejo.
What did you just call him?
Bandejo. It's Spanish for asshole.
No, it's not. That's pendejo with a P.
Seriously?
Yes.
You mean all this time I think I've been insulting people, I haven't been saying anything to them?
No, you have been calling them a cucumber.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I see, now his friend just gave you the finger.
Hey, screw you, Kyle!
How do you know his name is Kyle?
He's got a beanie on his head. He's a Kyle.
What?
It's a derogatory term for a Jewish person. A Kyle.
Oh, God. Oh, wow. Wow. The word you were looking for is so far away from where you were. I mean, you don't even know.
What do you mean? I mean, it totally shut him up.
Probably because he was confused. Okay, wait. Well, when we were down on 33rd the other day, did you call that bouncer a churro?
Yeah.
I thought I misheard you. Because the word you wanted, I think, was cholo.
Oh, this is awful. I mean, this means that every argument I've gotten into, I've got to reevaluate. It was just, these are my go-to comebacks, you know? I mean, I'd shut everybody down like that bouncer.
Probably because he was a churro. Hey, why'd that guy call me a delicious breaded fried treat?
Damn it!
Okay, wait. If you were going to insult a black person, not that you would, but if you were, what would you call them?
A Mulan.
Okay, see, that is a Disney animated feature starring Eddie Murphy. Hey, I don't like you. You're a blockbuster children's film.
Oh, come on.
Sorry.
What's the matter with me?
No, don't get upset about it. It's just you don't have a flair for the foreign insults. Just keep it easy, you know. Use English words. Try to be personal, you know, and don't try to fancy it up so much.
Hey, is that your face or did your neck take a shit?
Yes, that's great, exactly. And look how pissed off he's getting.
Oh, they're getting bigger the closer they get.
Oh, you want to run?
Hell yeah, pendejo. Let's get out of here.
I-24.
I've been sitting in this chair so long my ass hurts. It's affecting my sciatica.
You don't have sciatica.
Oh, what do you know?
I know you don't have sciatica.
N-45.
In 45, the world was a better place. The war had just ended. My husband came home. He wanted to be on top of me every chance he got.
With your girth, Mabel, you're lucky he could get on top of you at all.
Hey, I wasn't always this size. I used to be a model, you know that.
You had one modeling job for a diet ad. You were the before of the before and after.
Like I said, I was a model.
G-57.
Jeez.
He seems bored to be here, kids these days.
Can you blame them?
They don't have any work ethic. No work ethic.
Who'd want to be around the likes of you?
You? What's got your girdle today? You're in a worse mood than usual.
I'm premenstrual.
You're postmenstrual.
Oh, what do you know?
I know you haven't been premenstrual or even menstrual in years.
Oh, 70.
Oh, 70.
I remember when I was 70.
How can you remember that far back?
Listen to you. You sound like a child.
I am a child compared to you.
No. You're a fussy old goose with hypochondria.
Well, you're an old bitter cow in need of a bull. Oh, well, yeah. Bingo!
Well, gee, thanks.
Can I help it if I won?
Who's gonna keep me company?
Well, maybe I could, stick around. I've got nothing better to do.
You're damn right you don't.
Hey, Mabel.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're still alive.
I'm glad you're still alive, too.
By a mugger in disguise.
Oh.
money away. I was slinking through the park one day, afraid to even go that way.
Well, she had a can of mist, so I turned it in her face.
From the spray. I was stalking through the park one day for karate classes I had paid.
Overconfident from class, I quickly kicked her ass.
Got a gun. Stroll through the park each day.